In this video, we'll cover how you can run your WordPress website locally from your own computer. That means by the end of this video, you'll have a copy of your WordPress website on your own device that you'll be able to change and manipulate even though you don't have an internet connection. This is super helpful for two main reasons. First, you'll always have a backup copy of your website in case anything goes wrong. And second, you'll always be able to test out changes before you make them on your hosted website, which is on the internet. This WordPress website that you can currently see is running from my own computer entirely. Even if there were no internet connection, I would still be able to access it because I've downloaded the database and all the files for the front end. There are going to be three things that you need for this. First is going to be FileZilla to transfer files between your computer and your host. Second, you will need Xampp, which is an open source web server solution that will allow us to create a Localhost web server. And the third one is optional, but I recommend it nonetheless, which is MySQL that will allow us to work with a database. I won't be walking through the installation of each of these three software tools, but I'll leave all the necessary information for you to set up everything you need down in the description below. The first step that we need to take is we need to download all the files and databases that we use for our website onto our computer. Right here, you can see that I'm in the control panel of my web host where I can download the databases that belong to my website. Needless to say that this might look a little bit different for you at the moment because it depends on the host that you are using. But in any case, it doesn't matter what it looks like, every host will allow you to download the databases tied to your website, so make sure you do that. In my case, you can see that I only have one database, which is in use, and it's a MySQL database, which is tied to my WordPress website. If I go on to phpMyAdmin, you can see the contents of this database. And you will see that the structure of this database is pretty much the standard one, the one that you would see for pretty much all WordPress websites. So to download this database, all I need to do is I need to click on Export Dump. Then in my case, I need to choose a folder where I'm going to export it to. I'm going to put it there. And in addition to that, I'm going to also automatically download the dump after its creation and press OK. This will take a couple of moments, but then in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, you can see that this small icon pops up and it shows me that I have a downloaded version of my database. Now that I have a downloaded copy of my database, I can close the browser window and I can open up FileZilla. FileZilla is a free software that allows us to transfer data between the client and the host. In this case, we're going to be using it to download all the files that make up our website from the host to the client, which is our computer. I'm going to create a connection between FileZilla and my host by putting in the host, the username, the password, and pressing on Quick Connect. Afterwards, I get this dialog box with some user-specific data, and I'm simply going to press on OK, and once I do that, the connection is established. You can see here that on the right side, I have all the files that are on my host, and on the left side, I have everything which is on my computer. On the right-hand side, so within the files that I have on my host, I'm going to navigate to the file that belong to my WordPress website. In my case, these files are located in HTTP docs, so I'm going to click on that. Then I'm going to click on prod.env, and everything within the prod.env folder is what makes up my WordPress website. So I need to transfer all the files and folders on the right-hand side to my local computer, which is displayed on the left-hand side over here. And more specifically, these files and folders that make up my website need to be placed within the Xampp folder, and then within that folder, it needs to land in htdocs. I want to be clear about one thing over here, which is that this is not a random folder on my computer. Specifically, this is the root directory for the web server that we're going to use. You will also have this folder on your computer if you have installed Xampp. You can see that on the left-hand side, I've already prepared the WordPress folder, which is in my htdocs file. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the right-hand side and I'm going to mark all the individual files and folders that belong to my website, which are on the host, and I'm going to drag them and drop them into the WordPress directory, which is in the htdocs file on my computer. As soon as I do that, the file transfer starts, and we'll have to wait just a brief moment until the files are transferred, but I'm going to speed up the footage for that. Up until this point, we have downloaded all the files and folders from our website, and we have also downloaded the database. In the next step, we're going to make a few small changes to both the database and the website files that will allow us to run the website locally. Let's start off by handling the database first. So I'm going to go into MySQL Workbench and I'm going to press on localhost and log in by using my username and password. Once I've logged in, I'm going to right click within the schemas and click on create schema. When I enter the name of my schema, it's important that I use exactly the same name that it had when I was using it on my host. After entering the name, I can go to the bottom right corner and click on apply. And then in the next window that pops up, I'm going to click apply again. And you'll see that in the left-hand side of my screen, I have this empty schema that has currently no tables, views, or anything else. Now we are ready to import the database that we downloaded earlier. To do that, we're going to click on Server and on Import Data. Under the Import options, you can see that I can import from Dump Project Folder. Now I need to make sure that the file type over here is an SQL file. So I need to unzip the folder that I downloaded earlier. So I'm quickly going to open up my file explorer, go onto the downloads, and then right click onto the zip file that I downloaded earlier with my database inside. In the drop-down menu that appears, you'll have this option to extract all. And after I click that, it's going to ask me where I want to extract, and I'm simply going to extract it into the same folder that I'm already in. And so I'm going to press that, and you'll see that the file is now extracted within my downloads folder. Once that's done, we can close the file explorer and go back into MySQL, where we can now search for the file we just extracted. So I'm going to go here onto the three dots on the right hand side, and I'm going to click on this PC, downloads, and click on the SQL folder that we've just unzipped. Then click on OK, and you'll see that it now appears under the selected database objects to import, and then I can start the import on the bottom right-hand corner. The log files are now telling us that the import has finished, and so now we can click on these two round arrows. This will refresh our schemas, and that will update the tables, and now all the tables are on our computer. To be able to access the database from our local front end, we need to go to the options, and then select the first 1,000 rows. This is going to select the entire table because there's less than 1,000 rows, and we need to make changes to the site URL and the home URL. We are going to replace the option value for both of these items with HTTP, localhost, WordPress. And make sure to apply these changes by clicking apply in the bottom right-hand corner, and then accepting the two dialog boxes that follow. Now that we have finished making all the necessary changes to the database, we need to make one small change to one of the files of our website. So let's minimize MySQL Workbench and open up the File Explorer, where I'm going to navigate to the WordPress files that we downloaded earlier. As stated earlier, these are going to be within the Xampp, htdocs, and then within the WordPress file. And in this file, you want to go down to the wp-config file, then right-click on it and open it with some sort of text editor. I'm going to do this with Sublime Text. Within this file, I need to make sure that the data points towards the database that we have now downloaded and not towards the remote one, which is on our host. So you can see here that we have the database name, which is still correct. Then as the user, I'm going to write root as the database password. I'm also going to write root. And finally, as the host name, I'm going to write localhost. Make sure that you save these changes. I'm going to do that by simply hitting Control and S. These are actually all the changes that we needed to make. So now I'm going to fire up Xampp control panel. And within Xampp, I'm going to launch the module called a patch. And just as a side note, you'll see that there's a MySQL module. Now, we don't need to start this one because we are using MySQL Workbench. Once you see that the module is highlighted in green, we can now fire up a browser window. And within the browser window, we can navigate to localhost localhost.com/WordPress. And as you can see here, my local version of WordPress is showing up. But there is one more thing that we do need to take care of, which is that if I now click on one of these blog entries, such as this first one, you will see that I get an error message telling me that this page is not there. Fixing this is actually really simple. All you need to do is you need to navigate to localhost, WordPress, and then wp-admin. And within the admin dashboard, it might ask you to log in. You're going to enter your username and password and then log in as you would usually online. Afterwards, you're going to navigate to the settings dropdown, click on permalinks, and within the window that shows up, you're not going to make any changes. All you need to do is you need to press on save changes, because what that will do is it will update the permalink structure. So now if we visit the website again by clicking on the website name in the top left corner, you can see that it shows me the website that I was at before. But now if I click on the blog entry, it will actually show me the post. And now we have successfully managed to download a local version of our WordPress website. We can now use this as a backup or to test out different themes or plugins without harming the site that is running on our host. All right, so we're gonna leave it at that. I hope this video helped, and if it did, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to this channel, and we'll see each other in the next video.